Okay, you guys, we are here at the Mexican restaurant. This is your menu. And we are about to order us some food. Me and my nephew. My son didn't want to come, and then my oldest son had to go to work, so he didn't get to come with us. He wanted to stay home and play video games instead of coming to get something to eat, and then had the nerve to ask me to bring him something back. Tell me that's not something teenagers do. Anyway, let's look at the menu and see. It's so good. What are you gonna get so you know when she knows when you come back?
What should I get?
Maybe I'll do the fajitas, quesadilla, or maybe I'll just do the chicken fajita. That's what I'm gonna do, just a chicken fajita. Y'all, I got a virgin pina colada. That pina colada is good.
He came out, and it was like 10 in the night, and he came out and said, turn your music down now. She's like, no, my music isn't even that loud. And I don't remember what happened next, but something happened next.
Your mom cursed him out?
No, he didn't. But that guy, he's always complaining. But then the other guy next to us, he's really chill. He's a nice guy. Like, if we're making noise, he would come out there. He would be like the Italian guy. He said, turn your music down, like screamed at her. He said, guys, can you please turn your music down? He barely.
You guys, this is my food. Oh my gosh. It's stuffed chicken in tortilla wrap with guacamole, fried tomatoes, cheddar cheese. It looks so good. I never had it before, but this is enough for like 3 people. And I love how big the serving plate is. Y'all, I could not eat my food. It was so good. But it was a big portion. So I'm taking all of this home. Eartha has some food for later. Or the kids will probably snatch it up before I get to it. But it was really good. About to run to Aldi's and then go home because I have the prayer line at 8 o'clock. So my son got cookie head. This is another cookie spot. It's like cookie crumble around here. So they're very expensive, but we wanted to try it. So this is called the Barbie cookie. It's kind of like a confetti cookie. It feels hard. Cookie crumble cookies feel just a little bit more soft and moist, but when we bite into it, we'll really get to see. But this is called the Barbie cookie. And this one is called cookies and cream. This one looks really good. And lastly, this looks like the original chocolate chip with extra chunk. So I'm gonna let you guys know how this tastes. And again, this is from CookieHead. Hey you guys, so I hope you enjoyed the vlog so far. I know this vlog was very short, but I have been going through a lot in my personal life, so I gave what I could give this week. I'm going through so much on my job. I'm transitioning. I put in my resignation with my job. There was just no room for growth and to grow within the company, and so I was becoming more and more unhappy every time I would clock into work. And I just didn't have any more peace there. I just felt like every day I kept asking myself, like, what am I doing here? You know, what is my purpose here? just little stuff like that I kept asking myself, and I just got so uncomfortable, and I was like, you know what? Let me put in my resignation. So I'm stepping out on faith. I'll have all next week off, and my last day is going to be on Friday. But anyway, I was in my bed and I was just watching some TV, and I turned off the TV because I'm like, I just need to talk to God. I need to hear from God because I need strategic directions on what to do in my career, in my finances, just in my every area of my life, period. And I knew that I would find the answers in the Word of God. So I decided to go to the book of Habakkuk. And I don't know, Habakkuk, his name has just been, he's a prophet from God who was called from God. And Habakkuk, when I was like, God, where in the Bible should I read? Because originally I'm reading the book of Exodus, but Habakkuk just came into my mind. So I know the Holy Spirit put that in my mind. And as I'm reading Habakkuk, Habakkuk is living in a country where the Chadians, I know I'm saying the name wrong, there were a tribe who dominated the whole country, and they were causing a whole lot of destruction, violence, strife, and contention started to arise within the country. And so Habakkuk was constantly just like crying out to the Lord, you know, all this is going on in our nation. Father, you know, God, would you answer me? Why won't you hear me? And then God does eventually answer him because, you know, he's a prophet from God, and God speaks to all of us and he speaks to his prophets, but he spoke to him and, you know, kind of brought Habakkuk some understanding. And as I was reading it, I started, you know, just to see where I can place myself in the text and just kind of, you know, because right now, even in the times that we're in, there's a lot of violence, there's a lot of contention. And how do we get through that? You know what I mean? Like, how do we get through that, God? Help us get through that. And so it brought me a lot of clarity, because a lot of the same thing that was going on in Habakkuk's country is going on now. But as I was reading through it, and my Bible is also a study Bible, it says here, the troubled times of life may actually be the high places of spiritual growth for the believer who remains stable when tested by God. So when we go through troubles, times, and hardships and tests from God's, that is to help us spiritually grow, to help us to be steadfast, to help us to endure, to help us to be patient, and to help us to build character. So, you know, whatever comes up against us, just know that God has us, has to remember and to know that, and Habakkuk encouraged me, that God will still speak to you and direct you through the midst of all of that. You're under the authority of God. Right? You serve a God who created all things. So God is going to take care of you in the, no matter what's going on in your life, no matter what's going on in your nation, God has you in the palm of your hands, and he will turn all evil meant against those that love him. He's going to turn it out for good, because the devil doesn't know all things. God knows all things. And because God knows all things, he is going to bring those things forth to bring blessings in your life and to help prosper you and to get you through those things. And something that really stuck out to me that is also going to be my prayer, that Habakkuk started to speak and cry out and pray out to God at the end of the chapter. It's Habakkuk chapter 3, and it's let's go from verses 18. Yet I rejoice in the Lord. I will shout in exultation in the victorious God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength, my source of courage, my invincible army. He has made my feet steady and sure like hind feet, and makes me walk forward with spiritual confidence on my high places of challenge and responsibilities. So that's Habakkuk, how he ends his story, his book, and everything that he was talking to the Lord. So just know that the Lord is your strength. He's your source of courage. And that no matter what you're going through, that he is going to get you through. So this kind of brought peace to me. And even when, before I emailed out my resignation letter to my supervisor, to HR, to my team lead, because I CC'd all of them in, I was going back and forth. Like, I was just hovering over the send button. Like, should I send this? Should I send this? Should I send this? Should this be my last week? And I just did it. I just sent it. And once I hit send, I felt so much peace in my heart. It's like I didn't have any worry. And then I started to question myself, like, oh, why are you not worrying about anything? But when God gives you peace, you know it's from God. And you just have to be obedient to that. And then just allow His Holy Spirit to guide you. And He will. He will. So I'm going to keep you guys updated on how everything is working out with the job. The last 3 days that I'm going to be there, because I'm going to work Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then that's it. And then my new job starts on the 21st. There's two jobs that starts on the 21st. I just have to choose which one. So I'm just going to pray about it, wait for God to answer which one is the best move for me during this time in my life, because I really need to hear from God on this. I don't want to hear people's opinions about it. I want this to be God say, this is a go. Go in this way. So anyway, I hope you guys are blessed. I hope you enjoyed the vlog. Follow, subscribe, share. If there's anything you want to see, anything you want to review, anything you want me to try to cook, whatever it is, leave it down below. Engage with me. Leave your prayer requests. I will pray for you and pray for me. See y'all later. Bye.